Hey guys, this is Paleo Vlog 13. This diet, this paleo diet, is pretty meat heavy, pretty protein heavy, and it got me thinking about other hunter-gatherer, because it's based on, you know, it's supposed to be like a hunter-gatherer style diet. So it got me thinking about other hunter-gatherer diets, and I thought about what the Inuit eat, who live up in the Arctic Circle, and up there they can't grow like fruits and vegetables or very much at all, so they rely really heavily, apart from what they can gather. I just read a little bit, you know, they can gather some berries sometimes, some kelp from the sea, but it's all meat. And it turns out that they can get some of the vitamins that they would do from plants actually from the livers, for example, and the brain of some animals, the like they have seal brain and stuff like that. So it doesn't sound particularly appetizing to us, but that's how they can get those vitamins in. And as I say, from the kelp when they can get it, and from the berries and things like that. And their diet, I kind of thought, oh well, is it like a ketogenic diet, because they have a lot of fat as well, a lot of blubber, like a lot of whale and the skin of the whale and the blubber and the fat. But because of the high protein content, they're getting some gluconeogenesis, which is when your body breaks down proteins and turns them into glucose. And they've actually found that this process is done in your liver, like these proteins are broken down and turned into sugars in your liver, and because of this, because they're so adapted to this, they actually have larger livers, which I found pretty interesting. So they're so well adapted to this process of gluconeogenesis that they've got larger livers than the rest of us. So that's pretty interesting. Yeah, so it's not ketogenic because of the gluconeogenesis. But still a high fat content, and they're getting those vitamins. And a lot of the time, apparently, they're eating this meat raw, or, you know, like just fresh. So, apparently meat has a higher carbohydrate content when it's fresh. And a lot of these marine animals, actually have some glycogen stored in the protein and in the tissue to help with the freezing temperatures up there. So yeah, I found it quite interesting anyway. But that's it for today, guys. See you tomorrow.